One of the big questions you should be asking yourself if you're moving to Alaska is, which town should I live in? So in this video, I'm going to be talking about primarily the towns I'm most familiar with being in South Central Alaska, and we'll be looking at Anchorage, Palmer, and Wasilla. So we'll kind of be going into the pros and cons, what's good about certain communities, what's not, and I'm not going to be steering you in any direction. There's going to be a town for everybody, and certainly, you know, take a look and see what else also is available in the state. These are just the ones I'm most familiar with, and you know, everyone's going to have a different flavor of what they're looking for, so there's something for everybody, so not steering you in any direction. But let me go and jump into that in just a minute. For those of you who haven't done already, do make sure you give this video a like and subscribe and all that good stuff. And let's jump into today's video. Now, the first city we're going to look at is Wasilla. So Wasilla is pretty good in a lot of ways. So the homes are going to be newer out there. Cost of living is going to be low. You're going to have conveniences of having, you know, kind of the stores. You have a lot of the big box stores that are going to be out there. And yeah, I mean, property taxes and cost of living is going to be pretty low out there. You're going to have a lot of conveniences and a lot of like local restaurants also there as well. So you don't really get that feel of being off grid. You also have less restrictions on what you can do with your land as opposed to Anchorage. So that's all really good stuff for Wasilla. Now on the con column, the things that aren't good about Wasilla, what I would say is, number one, you can have some pretty strong winds out there. Just the way that the mountains are arranged in the area, you can get some pretty gusty winds going through there. Secondly, KGB Road. You have a lot of people who live on that road. It's only a two-way road right at the minute. They are working on expanding it. But for the meantime, it's gonna be pretty congested, and if you live over there, you have to kind of pick the time that you're going to be commuting out of that area pretty carefully. So yeah, just something to look out for. Next thing is that the roads in kind of downtown Wasilla, they definitely need some work. I feel like I'm bottoming out my little Honda Accord every time I drive through downtown Wasilla. So they definitely got to work on some potholes. Finally, I mean, I would say that this probably isn't something that's out of the norm for the rest of the country, but there are sales taxes in Wasilla. So they don't have it in Anchorage. That's why I bring it up. So that's going to be Wasilla overall. You know, a great little town. One thing I would also mention, the city planning in Wasilla, not really been impressed with it, and here's why. When somebody by the name of Sarah Palin was the mayor of Wasilla, she kind of just approved all of the businesses that were wanting to come in, you know, which is great. They had a lot of expansion and they blew up really quick, so that accomplished what they were going for. But the problem is, like, the city planning doesn't really make a whole lot of sense, and you'll know what I mean if you're driving around and be like, okay, there's a Fred Meyer's, and now here's a bunch of houses, and here's this, and here's that, and here's that. And it's kind of hard to get a feel for what the overall vision and plan was. So that just is what it is, though. Next, let's go ahead and take a look at Palmer. So Palmer is really great on your pro column, because it definitely does have a small town feel to it. If Alaska had a Mayberry, I would probably say that it's Homer. So businesses are primarily going to be small mom and pop shops. They do have Fred Meyer, but I think that's really about the only big kind of box place they have over there. Oh, Dairy Queen and McDonald's, but that's really about it. So it's going to be kind of tight knit, and they do have the state fair there once a year. So that's great. They have a lot of great outdoor activities, from hiking to, you know, four wheeling, hunting. They've got lots of great stuff over there to do as well. And also, they actually have a really good view of the Northern Lights when it's out there, because there's not a whole lot of city lights, and so you can see them fairly well. And you can actually go out to the Kinnick River and kind of stand out there on the sandbar. And it's a pretty good place to see the Northern Lights, just because it's so open, because it's an Alaskan river, which means it's, like, you know, half a mile wide. So that's really good. So all good stuff for Palmer. Now on the con column, what I would say is, if you're not into small towns, Palmer is probably not going to be your cup of tea. I have a lot of family that lives over there, but we're kind of small town people. But if you're someone who needs, like, a big a Dallas or San Francisco or something like that, and that's what you need to be happy, Palmer is probably going to be a great place to visit. I don't know if you actually want to live there. The other thing I would mention, a lot of the homes in Palmer are going to be a little bit on the older side, just because we don't see a whole lot of development going over there. Again, the people in Palmer really do protect their small town atmosphere, and they don't want a lot of development moving into the area. Additionally, I mean, like Wasilla, they do have kind of gusts of wind that go through there every now and then, so just kind of something to be aware of. Finally, I would say, yeah, sales tax. They do have sales tax over there, just like they do in Wasilla. Again, that might not even be on your radar, but yeah, just is what it is. Let's take a couple second time out here. So for those of you that are looking at coming up here to Alaska, I actually did take the time to go and create a relocation guide. This kind of goes through what it's like moving up here to Alaska, what there is to do once you get to Alaska. And when I say Alaska, South Central Alaska is primarily what we're looking at, but it does include some other areas as well. If that's something you're interested in receiving at no charge, certainly feel free to just go down below. You'll see my website, register to the website, put in the little message box, hey, send me relocation guide, and we'll go ahead and send that over to you. So do make sure that you you go ahead and do that, just to kind of see what's going on in the area. But other than that, let's go and jump back into the rest of today's video. Finally, let's talk about Anchorage, pros and cons. So on the pro column, number one, it is going to be very convenient. Okay, you're going to have a lot of the kind of bigger cities, mid-sized city conveniences. You're going to have like a larger shopping malls, indoor activities like, I mean, trampoline parks, roller skating, bowling. You're going to have more activities like that. So that's going to be great. And yeah, it's going to be a lot more convenient also, just on a lot of different levels, just because a lot of people work in Anchorage and they commute over to the valley. If you just live and work in Anchorage, you're essentially giving yourself a good solid 5 to 6 hours back into your week every week. So yeah, you can't knock that too much. And it's close to the airport, obviously. And that's another huge convenience, even if you're just trying to get to the rest of the state quickly. So all good stuff for Anchorage. Additionally, in Anchorage, the roads are gonna be better maintained, and the snow removal is gonna be a lot faster. Specifically in Eagle River, where I live, like, we usually have the snow out of there within a couple hours of getting a big snowfall. So that's really good. And the other thing is, I've kind of talked about in the for the other towns that we were discussing, there is no sales tax in Anchorage. So that's awesome. And we definitely make up for it in property taxes, but you know, that kind of gets us over into the con column. On the con column, I would say the cost of living is going to be higher, and primarily a lot of where that's going to be coming from is the cost of housing. So houses in Anchorage are not going to be very as new as what they are over in Wasilla. The average year built for a property in Wasilla is 2001. Average year built for one over in Anchorage is going to be 1981. So you definitely see a kind of a disparity there. Not a whole lot of new homes are being built in Anchorage, just because the municipality, just because the assembly has made it so darn difficult to build anything in Anchorage that there's not a whole lot of options. Sorry. Make sure you elect the right people if you want your rents and your mortgages to stay low. Additionally, cost of living is going to be a little higher just as a result of that primarily. And let's see, I am sure there's going to be something else. Oh yes, crime rate is going to be high. I've talked about this in other videos. Crime rate is not the same thing as overall crime. There's going to be a baseline of crime in any city that you're in, but you know, small city, small population, that is gonna, any crime is essentially gonna do the work of 10 people in a bigger city. So yeah, just kind of look at your crime maps that you're gonna be, of area you're moving into, to make sure you're comfortable with the flavor of crime in the area. But that's gonna be the three big towns that we're looking at here. I sure hope this was useful. If it has, give this video a like. And if you need to reach out to me directly, do so through my Facebook page. The link for that is going to be down below. Thank you for listening, and we'll talk with you next time.